Hi guys, today we're gonna talk about limiting beliefs. Lots of people, lots of motivational speakers talk about limiting beliefs, but what are the limiting beliefs? What are they talking about? It's a modern, fancy, popular word, but it's hard to understand what do those smart gurus mean when they talk about limiting beliefs. So today I will try to explain to you in a simple example, and you will understand what limiting beliefs are and why do we need to get rid of them. My name is Elena Semenek. I'm a psychologist, and this is my YouTube channel, Psychology of Happiness. Welcome. If you're new to my channel, I'm glad to see you. Please subscribe, because here I teach you about money, health, relationship, love, self-esteem, and all the topics that might help you to become happier and more successful in life. So today we're gonna talk about limiting beliefs. I would like to offer you one example. Let's say you bought a sandwich and you put it in your refrigerator. Let's say you place it at the lower shelf. You know that the sandwich is there. If you live with your spouse or with your kids or with a roommate, let's assume that your roommate decided to put the sandwich from the lower shelf to the top shelf, and maybe he or she placed it behind bananas. So you're opening up your refrigerator and you're looking for your sandwich. You can't find it, but you know that it's there. You know that you bought it and you're gonna look for it. So you're gonna check all the shelves, you're gonna check the door of the refrigerator until you find it. Even if you can't find, if you cannot find it, then you will ask your roommates or people who live with you, have you seen my sandwich? I bought it, it should be there. So usually people, you know, will keep looking, you know, many times. You can close the refrigerator and you can open and say, no, I know it's there, where is it? And you're gonna keep looking until you find it. So this is your belief. When you believe in something, you're gonna keep looking for proof. Let's say you have a limiting belief that you cannot trust people. So when you go to work, when you go to the supermarket, or when you're among your friends, you're gonna look, you're gonna focus on a person or maybe multiple people that you cannot trust. You're gonna notice and prioritize among all other people those who lie, those who manipulate, basically people that you cannot trust. So you're gonna look for the proof, for the confirmation of your belief. Let's say you're in a room with 20 people and 18 of them are okay, you know, and two of them are liars. You're gonna notice those two people because you believe that you cannot trust people. Let's go back to the example with the sandwich. Let's say you did not buy a sandwich. So you know you have no sandwich in your refrigerator, but your husband was kind enough and he bought you a sandwich and brought it from work and he placed it in the middle of the refrigerator. The chance that you're gonna notice it very, very small. If you open the refrigerator, you know, your brain knows that there is no sandwich. So you're gonna think about something else. So you say, okay, what can I eat? I forgot to buy a sandwich. I must have some cheese maybe and some tomatoes. Maybe I can, you know, have a snack. You're gonna open the refrigerator. You're gonna ignore the sandwich that your husband bought for you. And you're gonna look for cheese or for tomatoes. The chance that you will notice the sandwich, which might be right in front of your eyes, is very, very small. And let's say if your husband placed it behind bananas, you will never find that sandwich. Why? Because you know, it's like your limiting belief. You know that you did not buy a sandwich, and if you're not used to your husband purchasing you one, or your roommate, or somebody else, you're not gonna expect it. So again, if you believe that money can bring happiness, you will ignore the opportunities in life that will help you to make more money. If you believe that there is no way you're gonna have a loving, caring relationships with your parents, then you're gonna focus on the conflicts instead of the good things that you have between you. If you believe that you can never have a happy relationship, and if you believe that men or women are always cheat, then you're gonna ignore people who can be loyal, people who are willing to commit to the relationship, and you will meet only players and some drama queens. So our belief is something that we know. It's not just a belief, it's like an internal knowledge. You know that this is a fact. You know that if you're gonna eat unhealthy food, you're gonna get sick. Then you're gonna be, you will commit to the healthy lifestyle. If you believe that you are unworthy of having a promotion at work, then you will never be able to get it. So our limiting beliefs, it's like internal knowledge, what we know inside of us, and we know that it's like 100%. We know that tomorrow is gonna be another day. We just know it. We know that when it's midnight, it's dark outside. This is the knowledge. We know that when you put water in the freezer, it turns into ice. So our beliefs are kind of the same. So our limiting beliefs is something that we think is a 100% guarantee. So that's why it's important for you to find somebody who can help you to see your beliefs. Since you have this knowledge inside of you, it's very hard to notice it. It's very hard to be aware of your limiting beliefs. That's why you need a mentor, you need a psychologist, you need a therapist who can help you to work on your limiting beliefs. It's not gonna work with your friends. The reason for that is that we usually pick people in our life with the same values. So I choose my husband who shares same values as I am. I choose my friends who share the same values as I am. So that's the point of having a friend, because we're kind of the same. We kind of relate to each other. We know each other. We're on the same page. So that's why when you look around, you look among your friends, you look in your family, you say, okay, see, my mom, you know, had a bad relationship in her marriage. My grandma had a bad relationship in your marriage. Two of my friends had divorced. So it's not possible to have a good relationship. It's a myth. You cannot be happy. You cannot live happily ever after. Why? Because all your friends, you all share the same belief. That's why it's harder to get rid of those beliefs, even to notice them. And when you work on your limiting beliefs and you start seeing differently, life differently, your friends, your family will pull you back. So you're gonna go to your mom and say, listen, I found this great guy that I feel that he's the one, I really trust him. Your mom would say something like, you know, be careful, honey. It's all just the appearance. You know that I struggle a lot. You know that you know your grandmother was in love for many years, and you know how her story ended. So be careful. Don't open your heart. Don't fall in love that easily. You have to protect yourself. Or something like that. So when you go to your friend and say, listen, I want to open my own business. I have this great idea. I would like to, you know, I need some money to invest. Your friend would say, oh, you're crazy. Don't do that because you're going to lose money. You don't know anything about the business. It's risky. So if your friend is not a businessman, if your parents were never owned a business, then they will try to stop you from doing what you really want. So that's why you need a professional person who can help you. Especially it's important that this person went through kind of similar situation in their life. So if I went through toxic relationship and now I have a loving, caring, amazing marriage, then I know what it takes for you to go from toxic relationship to a loving, healthy relationship. If I came to America when I had no money and now I'm running my own business, I know how to do it. So I can not only understand what you're going through, but I can also guide you through the process because I know every single step. I went through that. And they went through my friends' resistance. I went through my family resistance. So you need to find somebody like me who knows what you're gonna go through in order for you to reach your goal. So on this note, I would like to invite you to my private sessions, to my group therapy. I have some online courses, and of course I encourage you to subscribe to my YouTube channel so you won't miss my future videos. I'm always happy to share with you not only knowledge but also exercises and meditations that can help you to work on your own. And by the way, if you subscribe to my newsletters, you will receive 7 free self-development webinars, 7 free guided meditations, and 7 self-healing exercises. And every week I send also free newsletters with a new video or a tool that you can use to help yourself to be aware of what's happening in your life and to get next step to that will bring you to your goal. So please give me like, subscribe to my channel, share my video with other people, and write me a comment. You know, I would like to know what you're thinking about. I would like to know if you agree with me. If you disagree, please let me know to ask your questions. I'm looking forward to reading your comments. Thank you very much for watching again. My name is Elena Semenek. See you next time. Bye.